Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Today we will take a look at the use of colour in our projects. More often than not, we don't notice colour directly. Rather, subconsciously, it affects us without us knowing. The use of colour heavily applies to our personality. Take a look at objects sitting around you. Look at their branding. What colour is their logo? What is their base colour? For example, I have a bottle of Ice Mocha, SteelSeries keyboard, a bottle of Smirnoff, phone, speakers, and many more, but those are just the first things that I see while I'm typing this. Looking at their brands, I'm noticing a lot of warmer colours. The KRK speaker's base colour is yellow, the SteelSeries box is orange, and the others are all red. My phone company is Vodafone, their base colour is red. I prefer YouTube over Vimeo, base colour, red. The chair I'm sitting on is red. My favourite jumper is red. The cup I made my coffee in today is red. My mouse sensitivity is on red. Bag straps are red. Corn chips bag is red. The point is, a lot of warmer colours tend to grab my attention when selecting items. This also applies to apps, games, movies, and generally which companies or brands we look up to. Warmer colours tend to directly link to a sense of delivery. A company using a warm logo is likely telling us that they are fast at something, or that their product gives a sense of excitement. Popular brands like McDonald's associate themselves with red and yellow, fast and fun. On the opposite side of the spectrum are cooler colours. These are often used to deliver a sense of trust and reliability. Think of Facebook. We visit their site almost every day and have a large dependence on them for our social life. We need to trust them since we post photos of ourselves and share information with people on the site. YouTube, on the other hand, is a platform for unprofessional videos like this one. Videos filmed on mobile devices with very little content. Videos are easy to find, they are usually short and exciting or weird. We do not devote our lives to YouTube, we merely share something people may not have seen. Given YouTube is going through many changes at the moment, heading towards a more professional platform with add-ons such as YouTube Red, but Vimeo tends to have a direct link to indie filmmakers, indie games, and generally higher quality videos and short films. This doesn't necessarily appeal to the majority of people looking for quick and funny content. Let's take a look at some age range and gender. It is easy to fall into the idea that girls like pink and boys like blue. This is often the case through stereotype. Boys think they want blue because they have been told that pink is for girls, and vice versa. So targeting children is a lot easier in this case. When buying gifts, parents will often think in this manner. Let's move ahead to when children make a scene in a store. We've all seen it. They want the product that they see. This is because they are now capable of making their own decisions. So, what have they seen that they are so desperate to have? Well, it will almost always contain the color yellow. If you go to your nearest toy store and blur your eyes, the color that will stand out most is yellow. Children see in a similar way. They want the product simply because they want the product. No logical thought is necessary. Fast forward to adolescents and teenagers, and you will notice a shift. They can't make a scene in a store anymore. Devices that target this age range in regards to gaming consoles, mobile phones, and clothing use a variety of different colors because these people have now established a personality. Now it gets a bit more complicated to target a consumer. They don't have money yet, therefore they ask their parents who have to approve the purchase. So our target here are essentially adults. Adults usually already have an established personality, and this can be seen from their purchases. Think about people you know who are impulse buyers. What colours do they usually purchase as they buy? Red is often associated with impulse buyers. Think about that one stingy friend that never spends their money and what colours they own. Blue is for people like this, who want the same reliable toothbrush for the rest of their lives. Think about the people who care for the environment and what they own. Brown or green are good colours to target people that take environmental aspects into consideration. Think of that person that won't take any risks. White and black are safe colours. People will often buy the product because it isn't outspoken and therefore has a smaller impact on their social status. Think of that creative hipster friend that always has something new to show you. purple correlates with the creativity and imagination and often least seen for that reason. Arguably, the two main colors used in branding are blue and red. They cover a large range of people. The other colors are very specific to the consumer. Purple is used in Cadbury, and the company contains the imaginative aspects of Willy Wonka. The attempt to take chocolate beyond just being chocolate. Yellow in companies like IMDb and Subway maintain an optimism that have the consumer believe this is a happy place filled with happy people. In IMDb's case, you are often looking up the cast for a film that you enjoy. If you notice the yellow, you almost know that the reviews and the ratings are going to respect the fact that you enjoy the film. In Subway's case, it is the idea that eating Subway is just as enjoyable as eating other fast food. Also notice that the green they use, which associates the company with health and fitness. Orange is similar to blue, but on a friendlier basis with less reliability. Fanta is a good example of this. It is also the first drink that children will choose between Coke and Sprite. Nickelodeon also being very popular to use orange, giving a sense of friendliness. Even YouTube's own Game Grumps use a lot of orange, and in my opinion, it does feel like you are playing the game with them. Now let's take a look at digital application, because in our generation, most future products will be downloadable. Colors have less effect here because the people we target are exposed to thinking about marketing of a product, even though they are uninvolved. Let's think about how contradictory Vine's color scheme became. A product that focused attention on quick and easy videos, yet their logo and base color was green. They did not represent health, growth, or the environment, but still became incredibly popular. Snapchat, on the other hand, uses yellow, highly useful in this case as you are watching people you know and it is important to feel happy about it. Skype uses blue, a standard color for reliability, but years later is to be replaced by Discord, whose color scheme revolves around purple. This is weird because very little creativity and imagination come out of Discord, which I believe to be more common for gamers. So it is very strange that random colors work for almost any brand, but it can be explained using two words: noticing change. It is very common nowadays to want new things, fresh and exciting things that work, and are always available at the click of a button. We have become a demanding generation, therefore everything must contain a unique aspect or it will be swept under the rug. Using colors that do not make sense is perfect to fill in the gap for the next big thing. Consider why Vine did so well. Very little video platforms had a green color scheme. Noticing this as a consumer entices you to check it out, and before you know it, they are running a successful app, later to be replaced by Snapchat in regards to the fact that there was no video platform with a yellow color scheme. Out of TeamSpeak, Skype, and Mumble, all trying to charge me money, I tried to find an alternative. The online listings had many, but they all followed a similar color scheme. Discord stood out as being the only software that had a different colored logo. So the digital world consists mainly of unique color schemes. You've heard people comparing software and websites being too similar to one another, but the internet is built upon everyone trying to take over the old platforms. Talking to teenagers recently, I was shocked when I found out that they didn't own a Facebook account. Turns out the younger generation are on other sites such as Instagram, and very shortly the next website, app, game, movie, or song will be out to replace the previous. Using colors correctly can heavily influence whether or not the next product is yours. So thanks for watching, everyone. Hopefully you learnt a lot, and if you want to learn more about game development, check out my other videos and subscribe to be in the draw to meet Santa Claus. Oh, cool. See you next time. Thank you very much.